Welcome to this video. In this video, we'll discuss about rank correlation, that is Spearman's rank correlation. It is my recommendation before watching this video, you should refer to the previous two videos. That was based on a very simpler method, how to calculate the rank correlation and how to allocate the ranks to these variables. Now coming on to this topic, we'll discuss in this video about how we will give a ranking when you have the same numbers. It means twice, thrice, whatever the situation will be, it is very important to learn how we will allocate the ranking to the same number. So first of all, with some example, I'll give you about how to allocate ranking. So here, for example, in the previous video, we have learned about how to allocate ranks. It means either you should allocate ranks from highest value to the lowest value, or you can do also reverse thing, like you can allot first number, the number 1, that is rank 1, and also the last rank to the highest value in the column. So that is why we will first discuss how to calculate this rank. For this column, the rank is 1 and 1. But this is not possible according to Spearman. So that is why this is the wrong notion. In order to correct this, we have to rely on the formula. So here, this is the formula. It means the first rank and the second rank with the same number, we have to add these. So 3 by 2, it means 1.5. So for both these figures, we have to give the ranking, that is 1.5. Now the question arises, suppose in this problem, we have only two numbers. Suppose there is another 30, then what we will do? We'll just 1 plus 2 plus 3 and divide it by 3. So whenever you have the same number, n number of times, you have to add these numbers and divide it by the total number of these ranks. So here 3 plus 2, 5, 6. 6 plus 3, we can write 2. If there is 3 value with the same ranks, so we'll denote that, like for example, 2. But here, we are dealing with only two numbers with the same ranks. So proceeding with the question, we'll discuss here. So we started with the top, that is the highest value. So highest value, we allocated rank 1.5 and 1.5. So we have consumed two ranks, so that is why the next highest is 28 and we will allocate the third rank. Now for example, the next one, like after 28, highest value is 24. So here you write a fourth rank. Then after that you have this 23 and 23. So it means again, fifth rank plus sixth rank divided by 2. Here it means 11 by 2. So the final rank comes out as 5.5. So in front of 23, we'll write 5.5. That's a way to allocate ranks. Now we have consumed 5th rank and 6th rank, so now we will allot 7th and 8th to the next two figures. Now considering the second column, so in this column we refer R1, the next column is R2. So here if we followed that, highest value, that is 30, we allocated in the number 1 rank. So here also we have to follow the same method. Now here the number 1 rank goes to 32. Then the second rank is 30, then the third rank is 28, then the fourth rank is 27, fifth rank is 26, sixth rank is 25. Now we have two 24s, so that is 7 plus 8 divided by 2. So here we'll write 15 by 2, it means 7.5. So we'll write in front of 24 as 7.5 and 7.5. This is the method how to allocate these rankings to these numbers when the rankings are same. Now for example, another thing, like if we have to now calculate D, that is R1 minus R2. So to draw another column. Now we will requirement of this D square. So we require D square. So here D simply means R1 minus R2. So here R1 is 8, R2 is 3. So we have 5. Here 7 minus 7.5. So that comes out as minus 0.5. Then 3 minus 7.5. It means minus 4.5. 5.5 minus 6. It means minus 0.5. 1.5 minus 5 is minus 3.5. 1.5 minus 4 is minus 2.5. 5.5 minus 1 is 4.5. That is positive. 4 minus 2 is 2. Now with the help of calculator, we will find out the square of these values. So for the first one, we'll write 25. Now the square root of 0.5 is 0.25. So here when we square the negative value, it becomes positive. That is why we are writing positive 0.25. Then 4.5, the square of 4.5 is 20.25. Another square is 0.5.5, so that is why 0.25. Now 3.5, so the figure comes out as 12.25. 6.25. For 4.5, that is 20.25, and for 2 is 4. Now we have to obtain the total of this d square. So 25 plus 0.25 plus 20.25 plus 0.25 plus 12.25 plus 6.25 plus 20.25 plus 4. So summation d square is equals to 88.5. Now the question arises, what is the formula? So the formula, I have deliberately made it a delay in introducing the formula to you, because the formula is very different from the previous two videos. Here we'll write rank like R, then 1 minus 6 summation d square plus 1 by 12. Here I am rubbing this heading. 1 by 12 m1 cube minus m1, then plus 1 by 12 m2 cube minus m2 plus and continuous. So it means, first we'll write denominator. Now what does it mean? This is n cube minus n. If we have repetitive values, like for example in the first series, that is x series, we have two figures, 30 and 30. So that is why we have to introduce this figure. Here m means how many times a number is repeated. So here in this case, the number is repeated two times. So we'll take m as 2. Here m1 means we are referring to only 30. Now the next is m2. So the next number, that is 23, is repeated two times. So that is why m2 means 23, the next value. Now if we have more values, like for example in this series, in series y we have 24 two times. So that is why we have to take another figure. So the formula is in a continuous method. It means the formula will goes on till the point we are all exhausting the repetitive numbers. Like for example, we'll now put these values. So 1 minus 6 summation d square, total of summation d square is 88.5 plus 1 by 12. Here m1 means we are taking 2 times, that is why the 30 comes as 2 times. So we will write 2. So 2 cube minus 2, then again plus 1 by 12. For the second figure, that is for 23, it is also repeated 2 times. So that is why again, This is a 2 cube minus 2. 1 by 12, another figure is repeated, that is 24. So that is also by twice. So 2 cube minus 2. Close the bracket. And on the denominator, n cube minus n. So here n means total number, serial number, that is 8. So here we will write 8 cube minus 8. Now with the help of calculator, we'll just do this solution. So here again, 1 minus 6, 88.5 plus 1 by 2. Here 2 cube means 8, the figure comes out 8, 2 cube means 8, minus 2 means 8 minus 2, that is 6. So here I am writing 6. Then plus 1 by 12, again the same thing, 2 cube means the value comes out as 8, minus 2, that is 6. So again I am writing 6. And the third one also, that is also multiplied by 6. So you are closing the bracket, writing what is the cube of 8, so that is 512 minus 8, so that is the cube. Now the next step, 1 minus, that is 6, 88.5 plus. When you do this plus, it means that 1 by 12 into 6. So 1 by 12 into 6 means 6 by 12. And 6 by 12 when we cut it across like 1 by 2. So here I am writing 1 by 2. Plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. In the denominator, you have 504. So 512 minus 8 comes out at 504. So 1 minus, again, 6, putting a bracket, 88.5 plus 1.5. These half comes out as 1.5. 88.5 plus 1.5 comes out as 90. So we are removing this bracket and putting directly 6 into 90 divided by 504. So again, 1 minus 6 into 90 comes out as 540 divided by 504. Here I am writing this side. So 540 divided by 504 comes out as, so 1 minus 1.0714. Now we just have to deduct this figure, 1 minus 1.0714. So the answer comes out as minus 0.0714. So this figure which is written in the box is your final answer. So we can say that these two columns, like column X and column Y, they are negatively correlated. So the less correlation because they are nearer to zero. That is why this is the conclusion you have to write in the last line when you get the answer of this question. That is for this video. Hope you like this video. If you have any doubt, recommendation or feedback, you can mention in the comment box. If you want any other video to be covered in the series of these videos, you can also mention the topic of that video. And another thing, like for example, if you need any notes, any articles about economics and statistics, you can also visit our blog. That is given in our description. Thank you so much once again. Please like, share and subscribe this channel. Please subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe this channel. Stay connected, because when you subscribe this channel, you will get the notification of the new videos. हाँ, वंस अगेन थैंक यू सो मच, हैव अ नाइस डे।